transforming text into the audio realm.
Harmonically transforming text into the audio realm.
Harmonic Wave, transforming text into the audio realm. Our programs are produced entirely in the USA and read by professional narrators who are compensated for their services at prevailing union rates. We hope you enjoy this program.
Reversing the Aging Process Naturally by Gary Null. In the 1990s, following decades of progress by the health movement, more and more Americans are very eager to be healthy, to have greater energy, quite simply to live longer. We're in the midst of a revolution in the kitchen, which has altered our philosophical and practical approach to eating. Healthy, organic, even live foods have found their way into many people's diets. We are finding that there is a turning point. What is that turning point? It is a quest for individual health and fitness. Today, anyone who is concerned with health must begin to embrace some new concepts, which we call antioxidant fitness and immune fitness. Just as our society came to value cardiovascular fitness in the past few decades, we now understand the role of our immune defenses and antioxidant defenses in helping us be optimally well. Antioxidant fitness refers to our ability to neutralize free radicals, the dangerous molecules in our bodies that can impair cells and set the stage for many chronic health disorders. Immune fitness refers to our ability to combat foreign invaders like viruses and bacteria, parasites and fungi. In the United States and other industrialized countries, antioxidant fitness is the preventative health for the 1990s. Long before many nutrients were officially named, it was known that certain types of food could prevent disease. As early as 1795, for example, a British physician found that fresh lime juice, which contains vitamin C, prevented the scurvy that afflicted many sailors who were confined on boats during long voyages. Nearly 200 years later, these classic deficiency diseases are no longer common. But in the meantime, scientists have discovered that the consequences of a nutrient deficiency can extend far beyond the most obvious and easily preventable disease states. Consider the immune system. Its competence may be impaired by a lack of various vitamins and minerals. A weakened immune system increases your susceptibility to minor ailments and chronic disease. How do you think we end up with arthritis? How do you think we end up with cancer and heart disease? Defects in the immune system. That means our antioxidant defenses, which consist of a very select group of enzymes and nutrients that combat free radicals. And they must all work in perfect synergy, and we in turn must work with the nutrition that we have been provided with to help feed the body the antioxidants it needs. And during our program, we're going to show you exactly how to do that. For instance, what are free radicals? Well, when a molecule loses one of its electrons, which are in an orbit around its nucleus. Now, I realize this sounds a little technical, but please bear with me. We're going to get through this, and you're going to understand this A to Z. The molecule stability is disturbed. Such a molecule is called a free radical because its electrons are unpaired and its altered energy state makes it highly reactive, meaning you can't control it. Let me give you a simple analogy. Let's say you walk into a room and the room is dark and you need light and you see lightning shining through the window. Well, that is a free radical. It's dangerous and you can't control it. Now let's say that you want light and you turn on a light switch. That is controlling the free radical with antioxidants. So you see, free radicals are something that are the primary cause of aging. They're the reason you get wrinkles. They're the reason that you get cancer and heart disease. They're the primary reason that you age prematurely. Eliminate the proliferation of free radicals and you quite simply, you slow down, put the brakes on, come to a screeching halt in the aging process. And isn't that the ultimate object of most of our lives, to be able to live a normal life. No, we cannot reverse aging. We're all going to age and eventually pass over. But shouldn't we be doing it at the age of 150? Not 65, not 75, not crippled and disabled? That's what reversing the aging process naturally is about. You see, we live in an environment full of toxins. We are in a sea of toxins. And either we can assume that these have nothing to do with our health and blindly continue to engage them in the form of caffeine and sugar and cigarette smoke and red meats, or we can stop for a moment and say, hold on, what can I do about this? And there we look at how to stop the free radicals from generating the disease process. That's what this program is about. Aging, trauma, certain medications, and some of the diseases can all lead to an increase in the production of free radicals. Even I, as an athlete, know that when I go out to train vigorously, I'm increasing the number of free radicals in my body. By the way, a few years ago, I was asked to give Greta Weitz, the world champion Norwegian athlete and Olympian and the winner of 10 New York City marathons, some advice. She had had some problems with having diarrhea during the marathon. And of course, television being what it is, it focused right on her the whole way. And it was very embarrassing. And I noticed the first thing when I was talking with her, I thought, whoa, she looks older than her chronological age. Well, she was outstandingly fit, but she was prematurely aged in her skin because she had not been taking the nutrients to compensate for the exercise process. Quite simply, all exercise creates free radicals that in turn burdens our body. I'm not going to suggest not to exercise. I am going to suggest make sure that you're dealing with free radicals, and we will show you how to deal with that in this program. The body naturally produces free radicals as it metabolizes oxygen. The oxygen-containing radicals that result from this process are among the most reactive types of free radicals. Your body must respond to the biochemical stress created by these dangerous molecules, just as we must respond to the physiological stress brought on by just everyday living. In the battle against free radicals, the body has two types of ammunition at its disposal. First, you have what are called a group of enzymes that can scavenge free radicals and stop them. Absolutely stop free radicals and stop the chain reaction. The body uses these enzymes as a natural antioxidant defense system to maintain a minute-by-minute interaction with the surrounding environment. The body's second line of defense against free radicals consists of three nutrients: vitamin C, vitamin E, and beta-carotene. And unlike the enzymes, which are produced by your body, the antioxidants must be obtained from either food or supplements. The aging process is not measured solely by the number of years passed, but also by the quality and vigor of our body functioning. Anyone who's interested in healthy and attractive skin should be aware that free radicals are the ongoing scourge that causes prematurely aged skin. Yes, but you can help protect your skin through the use of antioxidant nutrients and foods, which we'll be describing later on in this program. Satchel Paige was one of the great baseball players. He was an Afro-American, played a long career, by the way, had one of the longest careers in the history of baseball, and he made an interesting statement. He said, "How old would you be if you didn't know how old you were?" Well, that's why you shouldn't think of yourself any longer just as a chronological age. You're not just 40, 50, 60. You're also your biological age. And the biological age is what we're going to focus on, getting you younger than your chronological age. How much younger? Well, ask yourself this: how healthy do you want to be? And based upon how healthy you want to be, that's how young you're going to become biochemically. Another major phase of preventative health is immune fitness. The immune system has come under a sustained attack in the past few decades that can only be described as all-out warfare. The body is a marvelous machine, and the immune system does its job silently and with great competence most of the time. As a result, we may not truly appreciate its power in preventing a host of health problems, from mild ailments such as the flu to severe disorders such as chronic fatigue syndrome. Of all the body systems, the immune system is probably the most abused. People who have strong immune systems seem to fare especially well in this age of rampant infectious and degenerative diseases. Others are less fortunate, experiencing various effects caused by numerous types of immune imbalances. One type of immune imbalance is an allergic sensitivity which can cause a fair amount of misery on its own. With allergies, the immune system overreacts to otherwise ordinary items as if they were dangerous invaders. The normal, well-balanced immune system quietly removes such allergens as they enter the body. An unbalanced immune system overreacts to the exposure of allergens and may eventually become less effective at performing its very important work. The same stressors that tend to weaken the immune system can also cause it to be overreactive at the other end of the spectrum. Now, these stressors include pollution, chemicals in your food, caffeine, psychological or emotional events, and many others. When the immune system becomes weak, your resistance to bacteria and viruses and yeast will be diminished. Now, as a result, dormant viruses that the body has kept under control may become very, very active, come out of hiding, and begin to cause trouble. Now, that scenario is especially common in people with herpes. Have you ever noticed that the moment you get really stressed, let's say you don't sleep, you overwork, you're going through a crisis, what happens? Boom, the herpes virus comes out. And the herpes virus can produce infection all over the body, on the lips, the genitals, the buttocks. In addition to antioxidant fitness, then, each of us must consider the status of our immunity. Nutrients are highly effective in combating free radicals and boosting your immune system. According to the traditional school of thought in medical communities, we need specific amounts of vitamins and minerals each day to prevent related deficiency states, which cause diseases. Now, the same nutrients that prevent the classic deficiency diseases provide us with antioxidant protection. And a boost to the immune system may also help to prevent heart disease, cancer, arthritis, cataracts, and other specific health disorders. The protection offered by these nutrients is especially vital in modern society. Technological living has given us convenience, yes, but it's also increased the amount of stress on our immune systems and the antioxidant defenses. The modern industrial societies of the world hold the reputations as the lands of plenty. With the dictum of the 3 square meals a day, well, you'd think that malnutrition simply wouldn't be a factor, but the outward affluence of modern society masks some serious and pervasive problems having to do with our standard diet. Much of the food that flows so freely from our grocery store shelves is processed in a way that strips the food of its nutritional value. In addition to these ubiquitous refined foods, we consume large amounts of harmful products. What are they? Refined sugar, chemical-laden meat, fat-saturated animal proteins, alcohol, refined carbohydrates. Just look at what the average teenager eats in the average day. Look what the average American eats in the average day. When I was growing up in a small town in West Virginia, we would have almost all of our meals at home. We'd start with a very healthy breakfast, generally a hot cereal and fresh juice, glass of milk. We would always have a decent lunch, and my mother always made sure we had a nutritious dinner. Yes, you were allowed what were considered feast foods, but that was occasionally. Today, it's just inverted itself. The average American has coffee, bagels. They have some form of confection or snack for breakfast. They'll have a high-protein, high-fat, calorie-laden lunch, and generally deep-fried foods for dinner, and we wonder why we're so tired. We've allowed all this to pollute our body. Now, add into that our fluoride, chlorine, pesticides, and the like, and that's what I'd mean when we say we're swimming in a sea of toxins. We all like to think that our parents fed us well, but as adults, we must consider some blatant realities about Americans' eating habits. Throughout our lives, from infancy to old age, we eat an all-encompassing brand of lifeless, harmful foods that go by the name of processed, not real food from nature. No, this is by any stretch of the imagination a fallacy. foods processed so it can stay longer on the shelves. Well, let me ask you this. How good can any food be that can never go bad? I mean, I hate to think that something could be around for 5 years and we still think that it's healthy. By its very nature, processing strips foods' other natural nutrients through agitation, pressure, and extreme changes in temperature. Some food companies try to compensate for this innate inferiority by fortifying their products with a few vitamins and a tiny amount of minerals that they have destroyed in the manufacturing process. But once the damage is done, the food can never be returned to its original state. Even more disconcerting is the idea that processing may kill off nutrients and food factors that have not even yet been identified. As scientists point out, these undiscovered vitamins and trace elements are vital to our bodies because they work hand in hand with established nutrients. Quite simply, nature cannot be tricked. What nature has given us in its complexity and entirety, well, we should not be so thoughtless to assume that just by taking one single nutrient that was found in something in nature, it will replace nature. That's why a wholesome diet that I'm going to focus on is so important. Let me just digress and give you a point of view. There was an article that came out that was published in all the news media, and it said, in effect, that beta-carotene, something we've all learned to associate with good health, does not prevent cancer. And that was the end of it. Overnight, I'm sure many Americans thought, well, I don't have to eat all that beta-carotene. I don't have to eat my vegetables because, after all, the scientists said it doesn't prevent cancer. I studied the original research and found it was not beta-carotene, as in fruits and vegetables, which have been shown in hundreds of studies to prevent cancer of the prostate, of the breast. Instead, it was a single isolated chemical of beta-carotene taken in synthetic form, therefore not duplicating what nature had provided us. So you see, when science automatically assumes that it can do better than nature, then it's mistaken. There are so many ingredients in the complex of the food itself, in the whole of the food, that we haven't even isolated yet. So it's always better to eat the whole food. Incredibly, we've learned to like these processed, denatured, fractionalized foods, considering that our taste for processed foods can be traced to our...
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.